Everyone, I remember what I was going to say, so I had to put it into another video. I would have put it in the same video, but I forgot, so we're going to restart. Sorry. I wanted to say, now, besides formulas, there is something that we can do and we need to start doing in the TCG. Now, when you talk about the top tier decks in the meta, there's usually like two of them, two or three. Right now, it's Agents, Dark World, and like Synchro. It can be Plants, it can be Tengu, Synchro, whatever, Synchro. I'm just calling it Synchro. I don't give a fuck if it's Tengu, I don't give a fuck if it's Plants, I don't give a fuck if it's something else. It's Synchro. That's what it is. Those are the top three right now. Now, does that mean those three decks are the best? No, no, and no. It means people have not found a deck good enough to beat those decks yet. Which means they're good, but doesn't mean they're the best. A lot of times in the OCG, certain decks will be dominating the meta. And then one player will build a deck so ridiculous and so busted, it'll shake the foundation of the game, and everyone will net deck. And then that's a new top deck. That happened recently with Burn. Burn took first place at an OCG tournament. Now, the OCG, for the most part, defines the TCG meta, because people copy it and dick ride. That's what people do. Because they think as long as we do that, we can win a shonen. Which is flawed logic, because if you think about it, if you and 500 other people are dick riding the same goddamn deck, your chances of winning that shonen with that deck are like zero to nil. Because every player you verse is going to have anti-cards for you and know exactly how your deck works. Doesn't work, people. But anyway, I digress. Recently, a Burn deck took first place at an OCG tournament. I kid you not, a day after that, I saw Burn deck after Burn deck after Burn deck on forums, like, non-stop. There was, like, a spurious uproar of Burn deck, like, where people post their deck and say, hey, help me out, you know, make it faster, better, whatever, Kanye West shit, faster, better, stronger. That's what happens. People on forums are like, hey, this is my Burn deck. Can you guys help me out with it? And it's just like, people, stop dick riding. Don't you people, how long is it going to take before people understand the reason those people are winning is because they're thinking out of the box. That person refused to dick ride, and he made his own deck, and he found a setup that works good enough to fuck everyone else up. Now, everybody's going to try and dick ride him, and it's going to get ruined for everyone. Sorry. I thought I heard a kid behind me. Odd. Anyways. So, I mean, he thought outside the box and thought up his own deck creation so that he could fuck up the rest of the meta, and they were not expecting it. Now, this goes for a lot of decks. There's a lot of decks out there with hidden potential. People just don't realize they're really good yet. And people refuse to play them because they're like, well, agents are the best. And that's all they say. It's like, well, what about this deck? Oh yeah, that deck's really good, but, you know, it's a little slow. Have you tried to play it? Have you tried to make it better? No. Then what's the point? You have no idea how good the deck is. You have no idea how good the deck could be. That's just like with gadgets. In the Samurai format, gadgets were considered dead completely. They were like, there's no way a gadget deck can beat a 6 Samurai deck. Yet I went 9-2 at Anaheim and proved every motherfucker wrong. Sadly, I didn't win my last match, or I would have gotten top 34. I got 32. I got 34th place, which is fucking bullshit, but we won't go there either. But anyways, it's just like, you know, I proved to player after player, because when they saw I was playing gadgets, I keep doing it. Every 6 Samurai player I saw, the minute I summoned a gadget, they had this little smile on their face, like, ha ha ha. This kid's a noob. I'm going to win this easy. 3 turns after that, they're sitting there going, what the fuck is going on? It's because I had the balls and the audacity to run a deck so controversial that nobody's seen anything like it. They looked at that deck and went, what the hell? So did the person who was naming the match. He actually asked me before we started the match, the feature match I got, he asked me, what do you want your deck to be called? I was like, I don't know. I don't have a name for it. It's DeGadgets. That's all I call it. Because I'm DeGadget Guru. So he called, and so he went, go, go, Timothy Hucky, which I thought was funny because go, go, Gadget, you know, et cetera, et cetera. It was funny to me. I don't know. I thought it was pretty smart of him. But, and like in the feature match, I beat the fuck out of the Samurai player. And people were like, how did a Gadget deck just beat a Samurai deck? Because a player like me had the balls and the audacity to run something that other people said was crap, but I knew it wasn't. And that's what I always tell people. I always tell people, just because someone else says something's bad doesn't mean it is. It means they think it's bad because they don't know better. Nobody knows everything. Understand that. In this game, nobody knows everything. In fact, for most arguments in this game, people don't know anything. Because they only know what they're told by other players. Honestly, that's the honest-to-God truth. When you talk to people about card rulings and decks, all they're saying is copying their little friend's opinion on whatever it is, and they're saying it's their own. Which is not. Why the fuck does that guy have a boat in the middle of the desert? I don't want to know. Anyway, sorry about that. That was got a big fucking 24-foot boat in the middle of the desert on a trailer. He's lost. Anyways, so it's just I'm telling you guys, think outside the box. Think about those decks that do good at a regionals, but never make it to a shonen, and try and think why. Try and make them better and faster and stronger. You know, just be a Kanye West. I guess that's what I'm saying. Be like Kanye West and just go to the stars, I guess. I don't know. I'm actually doing this right now. I mean, everybody knows I'm a hardcore Gadget player. Gadgets are my, I don't know what you want to call it. Gadgets are my forte. They're my pièce de résistance. They're what I do. I'm the Gadget guru. I love gadgets. But I said to myself, you know, I should try and think outside the box and try and build a deck that most people don't think is good. Now, I built the burn deck, and then that burn deck topped in Japan, and everyone copied it, so now I'm kind of fucked in that regard. But that's not the point. The point is I tried. And then some other douchebag in Japan had an idea better than mine, and then he topped, and then everyone netdicked his ass. So that's not cool. Not cool at all. Does that mean I'm going to stop building my burn deck and making it faster and better and stronger? No. I'm not going to stop. I'm going to make that thing so ridiculous and so overpowered, you won't know what hit you. But that's for more of a deal. As I said before, I'm entered into the Dueling Network Tournament, the World Cup shit. The registration ends on the 18th. On the 18th, I will announce my deck list, which I just announced to you. Haha, spoilers. If you're smart, rewind this video. If you can't figure it out, you're an idiot. So, basically, I'm going to announce the deck I'm using, show you the deck list and everything, and then I'm going to record all the matches from that tournament, and I'll probably put music with them, unless you guys want audio commentary instead. I'll let you guys go ahead and decide on that one. I'll probably post both, actually. I'll probably post it twice. One with audio commentary, and one with music, so you can decide which one you like better. I think I'll do that, because I have the time to do that for you guys, so I'll do that. And I'll also, I guess I could try and do that. I'll try and do a, what's called a deck breakdown of the deck before the tournament starts. That way I can explain to you what cards I'm running, why I'm running them, what situations I'm thinking about versing, you know, all kinds of stuff like that. And this is going to be really hard, because in this tournament, there will be no side deck. There will be none. So I have to make sure that my deck is able to handle every other deck in the meta without side decking. Pretty hard. But anyways, that'll be it for another video. This is Gadget Guru. Catch y'all later.